In Pit Lane is proudly brought to you by Dynotech by Dyno Dynamics. For your nearest workshop, visit our website. And with the support of the Ramada Resort, Phillip Island. Formula Ford turned on plenty of great racing across the weekend at Phillip Island. Thomas Randall took the early honours with a win in race one before James Golding won the second race. But it was another Thomas in Tom Gretsch that came through to take out the overall victory in spite of not winning a single race. Gretsch grabbed second in the feature race after the leading pack of Randall, Adrian Lazzaro and Chelsea Angelo tangled at Siberia while fighting it out for the lead. Christian Marina in the Miguel came through unscathed to take the victory, but Gretsch's narrow second place was enough to give him the overall victory. It was an eventful weekend for the sports cars as well. Recent guest on In Pit Lane, Tony DeFelice, survived not one, not two, but three high-speed spins to take the overall win in his Ferrari 458 Italia. DeFelice won two races, with Steve McLaughlin giving his ex-Greg Crick Dodge Viper an ideal debut with a win in the first race to take second place overall. The feature race finished early for Ted Hughland, Paul Crosetti and Malt Fitzgerald after this scary high-speed crash at the hairpin formerly known as Honda. All three cars were substantially damaged, but thankfully all the drivers emerged unhurt. Ian Cowley and his Commodore romped away from the sports sedan field. Cowley won all three races to lead home the consistent Bob Gill and the RX-7 of Graeme Gillyland. The appearance of several under 2 litre cars added to the spectacle, with Barry McGraw's very fast Datsun 1600 leading the way home. And it was his homegrown muscle that beat the big American V8s as Gary Edwards led home a Tirana GTR XU1 trifecta from Andrew Javan and Steve Pillikers. In fact, it was another local in Carl Wittick's Falcon GDHO who was the first of the V8s way back in 10th place overall for the weekend.